Welcome back, everybody. This is NASCAR 1-Up Retro, round number 12, and we are at the historic North Wilkesboro Speedway. I'm alongside Duke and Zach for today's race, and this track is very old. It hasn't been paved in a while, similar to Rockingham. We might see some similar tire issues as compared to last time at Rockingham, but tires shouldn't be as much of a factor as attrition. This track is very small and it's very close quarters racing. What do you think we're going to see from drivers coming from the back trying to jostle their way up front, using the chrome horn to pass other cars?
Yeah, for sure. It's going to be a lot of awesome short track, spectacular racing. This track is known to be one of the classic favorites of NASCAR fans all around the country, so I'm excited and I expect a great show tonight.
Looking at qualifying now that took place just moments ago, looking at the starting grid, our points leader, John Martin's got the pole position, his second of the season. First time we've had a two-time pole winner this season with King alongside, Alexa Lutch in third with the three and fourth, and we've got two drivers making their series debuts this weekend. We've got Jake McMillan in the sixth starting 13th, and we've got Dale Johnson in the 25 starting 18th. We've got the returning cast of characters as well. Who do you think we should keep an eye on for today's race?
I think that you can't really count out John Hutchinson ever, because he always seems to be up there. So I'm keeping my eye on him today.
And remember, our last short tracks winner is not in the field today. Christian failed to qualify, so we're gonna have a fresh face in the winner's circle this time around. And with that being said, the field's all set up. We're ready to go racing, and we'll take you to the green flag in just a short while. And as you see, Martin and King lead the field around 3 and 4. The pace car's already on pit road. We're ready for some short track slam-banging action at North Wilkesboro, one of the historic tracks in all of America. The green flag is flying. We are underway at North Wilkesboro, and Martin and King are in a drag race down to turn 1. Who's going to get the lead first? It looks like Martin's going to get a nose out with Lutchen not far behind.
Yeah, that outside lane really fell back on the start, but I expect it to come in maybe a little bit later today. The 18 is going to decide to stay up there for now, Lutchen on the inside.
Yeah, he doesn't have room to get down to the bottom yet, as Gale and Lutchen are taking the line away, but he should be able to slot in fourth position as Sanders, our last time winner at Rockingham, tries to make a move on the three. But right now it looks like John Martin's got this race under control. He's got a decent sized lead over Alexa Lutchen coming off of turn 4 to complete lap number 2, and Martin continues to lead. Gale took a peek on the high side but thought better of it, as the top lane's not yet rubbered in this racetrack.
Yeah, and that's just one of those things that you see early in the short track races where, you know, you want to get to the bottom as quick as you can, because the outside lane just hasn't ruppered up enough and you can't really get the run off the corner that would give you an advantage by being up there.
I saw three wide back there. We're already getting into some three wide action for position. Yeah. As we look back a little bit, you can see Gale and King racing for third position. King's had a quiet season. He's been running. He's running up in the top 12 in points. He's in a playoff position, but it hasn't made quite as much noise as you'd probably like. That might change here today. As now Mattiello and Sanders go side by side. Remember, Mattiello and Seth Taylor in the 32 behind them, they failed to qualify at Rockingham. So they had some strong qualifying performances to get them up front here, and they're proving it wasn't a fluke.
Yeah, I guess that they really stepped up their work. Maybe they spent that extra time that they might have gotten from not making the race at Rockingham working on these cars today, and it's really showed so far.
Side by side for position, this is for 6 with Sanders on the outside and a number 3 hounding him for the position on the inside. As we pan out a little, you can see the cars fanning out down the front straightaway going into 1, and you can see Martin's lead is building. They're not really gaining on him much.
Yeah, he's got a great line. He's really wrapping the bottom right now, and that's right where you want to be. That's where the most grip is, and that's where it's going to be for a little bit of this race going on.
Fitzwater ran wide in 3 and 4. That's going to allow McMillan onto the inside. He's already up in the top 10. A solid outing on his debut race. Can he replicate what Lane Sanders did a week ago and win in his first start? We don't know anymore what can happen.
Yeah. And it looks to me like the outside lane is starting to come in a little bit more through 1 and 2, not quite yet in 3 and 4. I think it's because when you're coming off of 3 and 4, the exit is a little bit sharper than it is 1 and 2. So Well, we'll see how it comes in throughout the rest of this race here, but good signs so far for some multi-groove racing.
And don't forget, the front stretch is exclusively a downhill sprint to turn one, and the back stretch is an uphill jog to turn three. The elevation change could play a factor as well as in whether you can get the top line to work in the set of corners, as Taylor now tries to get 2-for-1 going under the 3 and the 81.
Yeah, and that elevation change is huge because it's going to change how much you're braking and how much throttle you're able to put on the exit of the corner. You don't want to gain too much speed too quickly when you're coming out of 3 and 4 by going downhill. So, you know, you want to ease off of it a little bit. That might be why it's a little bit harder to keep the momentum around the outside.
One driver making his way through the field is Ben McDonald in the 12. He started pretty deep in the field, and he's already made his way up into the top 15. He started back in 24th, so a good run from him as he made his way around Johnson in his series debut. And these four continue to battle for second place: Gale, Lutchen, Mattiello, and King. A Dodge, a Ford, and two Toyotas fighting for second.
Yeah, and Gale made it up into second place there. I wonder if he's going to be able to run up, catch the leader a little bit here. Lutchen was kind of lagging behind just a bit. Oh, well, Lutchen's going for it again, so I guess they're going to battle it out first.
And remember, at Bristol, Lutchen made that... It was Martinsville, actually, that Lutchen made a daring move on the inside to take second place at the very beginning of the race. Are we seeing the exact same thing happening here today? As we zoom out to see Martin with a massive lead, he's up to 1.4 seconds now ahead of Gale and Lutchen in their side-by-side battle, which seems to be settled in favor of Lutchen. As we see a car on pit road, this is a bit early for green flag pit stops, and he's not really doing anything. That's Kyle Corbett in the 42 Toyota. That does not look good.
It does not.
That looks like some kind of mechanical issue under the hood, because he is sitting there with nothing going on as the field comes by to lap him. It's going to be a long day for Kyle Corbett. Tough break for him.
Yeah, that is a tough break. Maybe at some point we'll figure out what happened, or maybe it was just a mechanical issue. Tough break.
His season's been very hit or miss. Had some great top 10 runs offset by several DNFs. Yeah. So this may fall into the latter category for him, as the field laps him a second time. Lutchen seems to establish herself into second place with King right behind. Lutchen's had a great season so far, but not yet a win. Will we see her try and chase down Martin, or will she settle in for the long haul, try and conserve her stuff for the later in the run when Martin maybe uses some of his stuff up?
Yeah, well, I'm looking at the leaderboard, and it hasn't changed a lot, but I think that she really has a shot here. She could keep smooth and steady. She's able to make aggressive passes work. So I think that if she gets up there to Martin, I think that she has a pretty good shot at leading the race. We'll see what she is now. Exactly the same. So it's just kind of biding her time right now. Not running her tires off the track.
It's still early in this race, too. We're all approaching the 1/5 distance, lap 20 we're coming up to. But King is trying to be on the aggressive side because he's trying to get around Lutchen and try and chase down Martin to try and give us some of that action we've been missing as we dive into North Wilkesboro's turn one. We swoop around the turn, and we can see the lead has pretty much stayed the same in the last few laps. Martin continuing to hold a 1.4-second lead over Lutchen and King. Mattiello and Gale have faded a little bit. They're now 2.7 seconds off the lead, so it looks like
Gale has lost three spots
since his run up to second place. So he might be doing the same thing Lutchen's doing, buying his time. As Sanders comes under fire from Cal Farrell and Peter Onjak in the 70. These two need some good runs because they're low in the point standings. Onjak, of course, being so because he started late. But these cars, as well as Fitzwater in the 59 and that white car behind them, they need solid points days to move themselves up the ladder and get themselves potentially in a locked-in position for the next race at Canadian Tire.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, once you start to look lower in the point standings, a lot of the cars, as I see...
I have to interrupt you for a second. We've got trouble, and it looks like it's the 9 of Oxendine. That looks terminal. That as he passes Kyle Corbett on pit road, that looks terminal.
That ain't never.
Add insult to injury for Kyle Corbett, but Oxendine has retired from the race.
Let's see if he had help.
All right, now we're on board, and it looks like, oh, Mashburn turned him. Mashburn sent him hard into the inside wall, and then, right into the barrels, right into the pit entry barrels. That is a tough break for Oxendine. He's hugging the pit wall, trying to get back on track, but there's no getting past that wall, and the smoke coming out from his car, his day is over after that impact. Tough break for a guy who also needs a good points run. He had a good run at Vegas, but other than that, his season's been pretty forgetful up to this point.
Yeah, it's that was a couple of really hard hits. Hopefully he's doing all right. And he slid right into the pit lane, so we're able to keep racing here without a caution.
We are still green with Martin holding quite a decent-sized lead here. It's 1.3 seconds over Lutchen and King. Mattiello has actually gained on them, so now it's a three-car battle for second. As you can see it on the leaderboard, Oxendine is out of the race. And if Corbett can get back on track, he may pass him, but we shall see. Now, that gap's actually growing a little bit into between first and second. It's now 1.7 seconds. Could it be because now King is applying a lot of pressure to Lutchen, and he's going to try and make a dive, but Lutchen just shuts the door on him.
Yeah, King is really putting the pressure on, like you said, making some moves here. Look, we got another look on the inside. There's the move.
This time it may stick. This time it may stick, but it got to come off four, race downhill to turn one again. But it looks like King will have the nose out. He will have the position going into one. But Lushin's not quitting in that 50 car. She's going to
and they are losing. They are losing a ton of time by racing side by side to our leader. As you can see, the gap has grown from about 1 point. 5 seconds to 2.2 seconds almost. We'll see. It's probably going to be even more here.
2.3, yes, exactly. So these guys really need to settle their differences and get after Martin, because he's got quite a lead as we complete lap number 30 of this race. We got 70 to go, so it's still quite early. Anything can still happen, but if things keep going the way they're going right now, Martin's just going to have an easy day.
Yeah, and something else to keep in mind, it's something that we saw at Martinsville. Lap traffic could play a large role. This is a short track, and it's a lengthy race here, a lot of laps. So we'll see if maybe the leader will catch some lap traffic, and that'll slow him down. But as for right now, it doesn't look like anything is slowing him down all that much.
it's now a five-car battle for second place as King starts to pull away a little bit, as Seth Taylor is caught the back of this pack, as he's going to try and go underneath Mattiello in that Windows Toyota. He's going to have the run coming off the corner, and I think he's going to get the position as Cal Farrell and Lane Sanders look on.
Yeah, and Gale snuck back up in there, up into third now. That's a pretty good comeback. He was falling behind a little bit earlier, but now he's coming back up through, so maybe the tire saving is working a little bit.
Maybe, although the gap between Martin and King is still about 2.2 seconds. They're not really making any headway on that as they drop another 10 to the leader. There's not much opportunity either to get around unless Martin makes a mistake, or unless, like you said, he starts catching lap traffic. These guys are going to have a real hard time getting back around him.
Yeah, they're going to really have to maybe start experimenting with a couple more lines, see if that outside has come in quite yet, but for now they're just kind of rolling, and unfortunately they're losing time by doing it.
Although another thing to keep an eye on, if they can't beat him on track, you can always try beating him on pit road. We're gonna have to make enough. We're gonna have to make one stop to get to the end of this thing. The question is when and where do you do your pit stop? If you're in second, third, you want to do it before Martin to get fresh tires and an advantage ahead of him, because the pace has dropped off about 3/4 of a second since the race has started. This track is quite old, as I said at the top of the show. Not quite as abrasive as Rockingham, but still very wearing on these tires. So they're going to have to come in at least once to put four fresh ones on and filler full of fuel if they want to make it all the way to the end at North Wilkesboro.
Yeah, and you can just see how hard they drive into these corners. I mean, it's a lot of engine brake, and it's a lot of using the track to slow your car down. And it's that really takes a toll on the tires.
As you can see, Mattiello has actually, in fifth position, has the point for fastest lap at the moment. He ran a lap faster than our leader, Martin, at some point in time in this race. Corbett's still stuck on pit road. They should probably take that thing behind the wall at this point. Yeah. They're having such a hard time. As we're looking at the last place car on track, Kevin Carter and Jeff Bolton, they are about halfway down the straightaway, the back straightaway, yeah. And Martin's just coming off of turn two now, so they've got plenty of time to work with as we approach lap 40, but at the rate they're going at, Martin will catch them. The question is, when will he catch them, and will King and Gale take advantage of it?
Yeah, I think that it's going to be, in fact, they just gained 0.3 on the leader, which is impressive. But I think that once these pit stops start happening and once the field gets a little bit more jumbled because of it, that's when the lap cars are going to really come into play.
That is true. And let's see the gap at the line now. It's down another 0.2 seconds, down to 1.5, as Martin's starting to lose a little bit of his lead to King and Gale. Lutchen's starting to fall off, as well as Mattiello, and Taylor has actually gotten passed by Cal Farrell. So, as things stand right now, it's Martin your leader, then King, Gale, Lutchen, Mattiello your top five, with Farrell, Taylor, Fitzwater, Sanders, and Onjak your top 10 at lap 42 of 100. But as you see, Martin's gaining more time. He just gained those 0.2 he lost on the last lap back. So things have stabilized with Martin out front, but King's going to try and find a line that works for him.
Yeah, it's really interesting to watch these cars go around to see kind of what's causing the comer and goer effect. You know, you've got, I think that it's all coming out at this turn four right here. I think when you exit a little bit higher, I think that you can carry a little bit more momentum. And that just allows you to get a little bit faster. And I think that King is doing it better right now. He's gaining a lot of time on the leader.
So far, so good for the driver of the 18. He wants to show us that he's a contender for a race win. And as he sees the gap between him and Gale's getting bigger, so he doesn't have to worry about right behind him. Let's take a few laps now around North Wilkesboro with King. The banking here is not that steep, but it's still a factor in launching you up the hill to turn three, and then slingshotting you back down the hill going into turn one as the gap to Martin continues to grow and shrink lap after lap.
Yeah, it's really interesting to watch how the gap changes because it just got wider, but it's pretty much stabilized at this point, I'd say. And you can see the line differences too right here. You can see that the 18 is running a little bit higher in 1 and 2, and a little bit lower. And this, I'm looking at the 26, he's exiting the corner. He's going really, really low on the exit, straightening it out and making it so that he's able to get a good run off the corner. It might help him stabilize his throttle because the tires are getting a little old and a little slippier.
There's some smoke actually in 3 and 4. Did we see some contact a minute ago that we missed? Because as you can see, a car ahead of John Martin. We're going to take a look and see which car that is that got it into the wall, it looks like. And it looks like it's Melee in the 44. Must have gotten up into the wall. You can see see the skid marks and the smoke lingering from the contact. Looks like Melee's going to be able to continue, and it looks like we're going to be able to stay green despite all this. A tough break for the 44 as he's lost even more time, and now he will definitely be the first one to fall once lap traffic becomes a factor.
Don't look now, but that gap between first and second has shrunk to 1 second. That's the closest we've seen it since the beginning of the race, so I'm excited to see a little bit of a battle for the lead here.
If this damage continues to plague Melee, and Martin catches him, that could open the door for King as well.
Yeah, but quite frankly, I don't think that King is wanting to have to use the lap cars. I think that King wants to catch him outright and on his own.
He's doing a good job of it. It's down to 3/4 of a second now. And that gap is not going up, so he's putting the pressure on. As we've passed halfway now, which means John Martin will clinch 2 bonus points in this race for leading the most laps in this race. He has led from the start of the race till our current running position right now at lap 52. And don't look now, but look behind King. There's Stephen Gale. He's closing in as well.
Yeah, Stephen Gale has been lurking. We've been talking about King a lot, but Gale is lurking right behind him. And I think that there is potential for a three-car battle coming up pretty soon here.
If they even if they don't catch Melee, it could come pretty soon. As you can see, the line difference, Martin swung up closer to the wall on the front straightaway. You'll notice that back in qualifying, they all did that. They all swung wide up to the high side to get a good arc into turn one. However, in the race, not everybody's doing that. They're sticking closer to the middle groove, as you see Martin and especially King and Gale do. Everybody's just hugging that middle, pushing to the racetrack. I don't know if it's helping them any, but so far it seems to be working, as the gap's now only 0.8 seconds.
Yeah, so if they're able to carry enough speed through the corner doing that, really, it does make the track a little bit shorter to do that. So maybe with the old tires, as we see King completely stop doing that there, but you know, with the older tires and everybody going a little bit slower, maybe that is helping having a shorter racetrack to go around.
The pace is slowing down quite a bit as these tires age. Not sure when we're going to see that set of pit stops in this race, but we know they're coming as Gale and King continue to chase down Martin. They took out half a second almost in that one lap.
I saw Gale swing high. I wonder if the 18 had a little bit of a checkup there that made Gale want to run the outside just in case. We'll see, though.
Ford, Toyota, Dodge, 1-2-3 in this race. The Chevrolet camps had a bit of an off day. Their best runner is currently Ben McDonnell in 8th. But Ford has 2 cars in the top 5. Toyota has 2 cars in the top 5. And Stephen Gale, the lone representative for Dodge up there. But all 3 of those manufacturers having a solid outing. And they all want to win this race and take a... Because the manufacturer standings are very tight as of now. Ford holding a narrow lead over Chevrolet. But that may change with how well the Toyotas are performing here with Mattiello and with King.
Yeah, and I also want to make note of that 44 car with damage. He's really holding his own up there. He's not really... the 26 isn't really catching him all that much, so he's hanging and just
doesn't look like it's hurt him. Definitely doesn't look like it's hurt him any.
So maybe a strategy call in the pit lane could help him out just a tad bit.
Yeah, as we see now, the last runners on track continue to be Carter, Ace, and Halleck, but they are about halfway down the back straightaway now and looking to see where Martin is, because it looks like
this would be a good view.
As these guys cross the finish line, Melee you can see at the top of the screen, but Martin's got a long way to go to catch these guys. He might not even get there if they continue to dice it up this much.
Yeah, that it was interesting earlier. We thought that Martin was catching them pretty good, but now it looks like these guys are just kind of. They've kind of stabilized the speeds, at least. Maybe Martin's keeping a little bit of speed in the tank there, of just kind of buying his time, not willing to make any mistakes.
And that gap you see is down to about 0.6 seconds, and as soon as I say that, it goes back up to a full second as Martin extends his gap over King. We're at lap 62 of 100. We're well over halfway done here, as now we see Martin lead the charge off of turn 4 once again, but the gap is continuing to grow and it's continuing to shrink. And that time by it grew by a few hundredths of a second. It's still about a 1 second lead over King and about a 2 second lead over Gale. They're pretty well strung out because Lutchen's 3 seconds back, Mattiello's 4 seconds back, and McDonnell in 6th is all the way 5.5 seconds back. So it looks like it's going to be a tough to catch Martin. But if anyone's going to do it, it's probably going to be this 18.
Yeah, the 18 is absolutely fast right now. And we have to keep in mind, since we're past halfway, the window for pitting and making it to the end has opened. So this really could be broken wide open this race if maybe we get some short pitting or undercutting. You know, I'm excited for the end of this thing.
Keep in mind, with how close the pit entry is to the racetrack, you could see some accidents getting on the pit road. As you can see, McDonnell in the 12, the highest running Chevrolet at this point, he started 24th, and he's up already into the 6th position. That's a good run from that 12 car.
It absolutely is. Yeah, that's a speedy Chevrolet right there.
And if you want to talk about good runs, if you look a little further back, you can see this 30 car of Caggiano. He started 42nd in the field, and he's all the way up in the top 10 now. Now, that's a car that's made big gains in a big hurry.
Yeah, and I mean, he's not terribly far behind. I mean, he's a little bit far behind, but if he could get a good pit stop, he could gain a couple of seconds, and with that kind of
speed, we got trouble in turn one, and it's the 6 of McMillan. It was his series debut, and it's all gone down the drain at lap 67. His race is over at North Wilkesboro. The smoke trailing from behind. It looks like now. The caution flag is out, and as the field comes off of turn 4, this is probably where we're going to see all our pit stops happen, is under the caution flag, and here they come. All the leaders are following the smoking car of Jake McMillan down pit road. McMillan will be retired from this race, but everybody else is still in a very strong position, and it looks like Stephen Gale actually may be the biggest beneficiary of this. He was on pit road as the caution came out, so Stephen Gale will be leading this race once we go back green. A major strategy decision, but it worked out so well.
Yeah, that's a big, big move by Stephen Gale there. But I'm watching to see if anybody can pass Martin coming out of the pit lane, because this is an absolute game changer in this race. So we'll see right here. Race off pit road.
Four tires going on everybody, assumedly, because they need the position, unless we see someone at the back, as you see Stephen Gale on the racetrack trying to catch up to the pace car. But bypassing him, he will be the leader, but going out of the pits, Martin will be first.
Interesting.
Mattiello leads Lutchen off pit road, Taylor fourth. King had a real slow stop. It dropped him down to fifth, which will be sixth in the running order once Stephen Gale cycles around to the lead. And then as the rest of the cars race their way out of the pits, as another car that had a terrible stop is the 81 of Lane Sanders. He was running in the top 10. So he's coming off of turn 4 with Fitzwater in behind him and Onjak directly ahead. He was running in about 13th, 14th, and
oh no.
Yep, man. And that's what happened. Fitzwater just turned left, and there was no room. There's no room for both of them. So curious to see if Fitzwater will have any damage after this, but Jake McMillan's race is over for sure. And it's a tough break, and for his first career start, he was doing really well. He was running in about 13th position when that happened. Tough break for the 6, but all you can do is buckle down and move on the Canadian Tire.
Yeah. That is tough.
And as you can see, he makes his way down to pit road under the replay to retire. And now we see Stephen Gale in the lead. What a strategy call by Stephen Gale to make that pit stop when he did under yellow. Under green, actually. He was down pit road. He was trying to get an undercut off on King and Martin, and now he's in the best possible position. He's leading this thing.
Yeah, he is. This is going to be good to see if Gale can pull ahead as much as Martin did.
And now we've got some new players in the top 5. We've got Mattiello in 3rd. We've got Taylor in 5th. King's dropped all the way back to 6th. Can he rebound from a slow stop?
That 30 car, he's lurking. He's in this thing now. He is quick. And I think that he could be a factor before the end of this one.
Lights are out on the pace car, so we are going green next time around. And no cars have gone a lap down yet, so we are going to have a single file restart. This is coming to the green. It'll be Gale, Martin, Mattiello, Lutchen, Taylor, your top 5. Then King, Caggiano, McDonald, Farrell, and Stephen Hunter moves up into the top 10 coming off of pit road. So the pace car pulls off, and we're ready for the restart.
Yeah, this is sure to be a good one. Martin hasn't been in traffic yet, so we'll see if that car is as strong as it was before in traffic, and it's all coming up right now.
Coming into the restart zone now, the flagman's got the flag in hand. He's waiting, green flag's flying now. We are back underway.
Look at that, Gale has pulled out just a little bit.
He should have a little bit, his tires are maybe one or two laps older than the cars ahead of him, but it shouldn't make that much of a difference.
Because they were caution laps too, so it's
so they all. Oh, and we've got trouble. No! We got trouble in the back.
That's the King.
King and Taylor made some contact there. We got a huge dent in the left hand side of Taylor's Toyota.
That was a major contact to the inside wall.
But it looks like he's able to continue, and we are going to be able to stay green here. But now what that's done is it's bottled up the field behind Seth Taylor. Now McDonald and Hunter are going under King, and it looks like Farrell's going to try and make a move too. Tough break for these guys, but they're actually making the best of it. They're still running in the top 10.
Yeah, and John Martin has not let him go. He's hanging right behind, so... We will see.
We've crossed the three-quarter distance of this race, and the gap is small. And checking to see the fastest lap of the race, the point's been taken away from Mattiello. Now Stephen Gale has the fast lap of this race at a 2016. Just 2/1000ths ahead of Chris Maley for that position, who actually managed...
That's a battle in itself.
And he managed to hang on to the lead lap, by the way, when that caution came out. It's a good break for him as well. But the battle for the lead continues to be Gale and Martin, with Lutchen and Mattiello lurking behind as we approach 20 laps to go.
Yeah, and these two are pulling away from Lutchen behind. They're almost a whole second ahead of her, and it's kind of what I expected. These two are very fast race cars, and there's a little bit of smoke right there on the front stretch. I'm not sure what that's from.
What that's from is that's from the 72 of Miles Mashburn, whose race is now over with a busted piston in that 72 Chevrolet. So his race will see an early end today as Gale continues to lead the charge off of turn four with Martin in hot pursuit right behind as we take 21 laps to go.
Yeah, and Gale is pulling away. I'm thinking that Gale maybe found something in that last run. He found a line that was working better, or maybe he's just, like, he's entering high, so that's maybe that outside lane is rubbered up by this point in the race, but he's starting to drive away a little bit.
And keep in mind, too, this is the first time his car has had clean air all race long. So the clean air on the nose of that Dodge is really powering him to some fast times as the average speed continues to climb back up to about 100 where it was earlier. And now, as we cross the 20 lap to go mark, now we've got about 18 to go now. Gale's got quite a big lead, but can Martin chase him back down? Or will this strategy pay off in dividends for Steve Gale?
Yeah, I think that was an excellent call. And even without the caution, I think that was going to be an excellent call. But really, it worked out for him. And that crew chief is looking like a genius right now, putting this 52 car in the lead.
For sure. And as he goes down in the turn three, Jeff Bolton's taking the fastest lap away from Stephen Gale. Bolton's running deep in the field and in the 30s, but he managed to click off a fast one. It's a 2015. So that point is now lost to Stephen Gale as we see Stephen Hunter's making his way up through the field too.
Yeah, here comes a move to the inside from the 51. It's not going to quite work out. When you go to the inside like that, you can't really carry as much speed into the corner. So when you enter high, you're able to go a little bit quicker and pull away from the guy that's trying to pass you on the inside.
Hunter started back in 19th, and he's made a good run up to 5th. And we keep praising him his season so far. He missed the season opener at Daytona, but other than that, he's been stellar, and he's actually made his way up into the top 10 in points despite missing that race.
Yeah, and another note, there still aren't that many Chevys right up front. I think that the 12 is still the top running Chevy.
The only Chevrolets right now in the top 10 are, as you said, Ben McDonald in 6, and Dale Johnson in his series debut in the 25. He's up to 10th now. So those are the only Chevrolets in the top 10. As you see this battle between the 75 and the 00 of San Donato as they battle for the 11th position. It looks like the 75 is going to take that. The good run from Johnson after Jacob Johnson didn't make the field today. We've still got a Johnson in the field, and he's performing quite admirably.
Yeah, it's working out for that 25 car, and it's a great-looking race car, too. I'd say big things in that future. for that race team there.
At 75 started 23rd, so if charge up to 11th is not terrible, but as we make our way back up, Matty Yellow is still having a stellar run in that 14. Mm-hmm. After failing to qualify at Rockingham, he's probably going to walk away from this with a top 5 finish.
Yeah, definitely, that'll be like a win for that team for sure.
Definitely important as he's trying to fight his way back into the top 30 in points. As we know, a top 30 points position means you are locked into the show for these races, with the exception of our upcoming race at Eldora. That race will have a special qualifying system where only the top 18 in points are locked in. So look forward to that race, because we will have a very special pre-race show with special heat racing coming at you from Eldora a little later on in the schedule.
Yeah, that will be absolutely awesome. But to bring it back to this race, we've got 9 coming on 8 to go in this one. And the 52 car has pulled away from the one that has led most laps in this race.
And that gap is about 1 1/3 seconds. So unless another caution comes out, that will be a very tough gap to close. And even if a caution does come out, it might not leave enough laps for Martin to really make a big charge at him.
Yeah, and Martin is now falling to the clutches of Lutchen and all those people back there. So this could get very, very tough for those guys coming in the near laps.
It's a 2-second lead between Stephen Gale and John Martin. And that crew chief for the 52 got to be real happy with that strategy call that put the 52 up front. He was running in the top 5 anyway, which would have been a good finish, but he knew he had to do something different to beat John Martin, and he pitted under green and got the blessing of a lifetime when that caution came out for McMillan and Fitzwater.
Yeah, when the caution came out, I think that I saw his pit box shaking around because they were all jumping up and down on there celebrating that amazing call that they made.
Coming to 5 laps to go now is Martin, as you said, is trying to hold off the side-by-side battle for third, as Matty Yellow is going to try and take another spot away.
Look at that.
This 14 car is on quite a tear. He didn't make the show at Rockingham, but he's making up for it now. He probably would have been able to have 2 good finishes if had he made the show there, because this car is on rails. It's a shame he's so far down in points. We could be good to see him every week.
Yeah, that is a bad fast car right now, and I think that he's going to try to make a move for second place coming up here right soon.
And in the same boat as Matty Yellow, props to Seth Taylor in 8th, despite damage on the left-hand side of his car after contact with King, who has fallen all the way back to 14th in this race, is now still running in the 8th position for Taylor, so a good run for him nonetheless, as we approach 3 laps to go, and it's Stephen Gale's race to lose. He's got a 2.5-second lead. He's just got to nurse it home for these final 2 laps.
Yeah, but he's not nursing it. He was last lap by was 100 mile an hour. That was pretty quick, because he wasn't running quite that fast in the last one. So he is pushing hard right now to pull away.
Average speed has peaked over 100 miles per hour again, as we're coming to the white flag this time by, and it's Stephen Gale with an almost insurmountable lead as the white flag flies for Stephen Gale. He started the final lap of this race.
Yeah, he is still gaining time on those guys behind him, and this really, what a turnaround for him. Earlier in the race, we saw him fall back a little bit, and now he's coming off turn 4 for the checkered flag.
In a race that was decided not on the track, but in the pits, it's Stephen Gale comes off a 4, and he is your winner at North Wilkesboro Speedway. What a finish, and what a strategy by that 52. They've got to be happy with that.
Yeah, absolutely. That was entertaining. There were comers and goers, and Stephen Gale came out on top, deservedly so.
Heartbreak, though, for John Martin, who's saddled with another second-place finish. He'll get his first win one of these days, but that'll still put him in a good position to keep his points lead. Matty Yellow of a strong run to finish third. Stephen Hunter up to 4th, and Cal Farrell slipped by Alexa Lutchen on the final lap to take 5th away. They never did manage to fix that 42 of Kyle Corbett, who's still sitting there.
No, they did not. Yeah, they're still working on it.
Lutchen, the race is over, buddy. Lutchen faded a little bit to finish 6th, McDonald 7th, Seth Taylor 8th, Dale Johnson in 9th, and Caggiano from last place on the grid to 10th at the end. What a race. What a victory by Stephen Gale. Pit strategy proved superior to Dominic Carr did not win today, but it was the best strategy that got the victory here today.
Yep, the strategy and clean air for sure has benefited the winner today, but that's part of the game. So if you can't do one right, you got to do the other. So that was an excellent race. I really enjoyed it.
And as we say goodbye to the short tracks for now, our next race is on the road course, a bit north of the border at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. So-